Are you ready to know?
Like me share to see.
Just a few scriptures I will read here.
Mangwalo je amalol malo.
First Thessalonians.
Araba le batosanalika ba pili chapter 4.
1 to 8.
Verse 1 to 8.
Are you there?
Amen.
Finally, then, brethren, we beseech and exhort you in the Lord Jesus that as you receive of us how you ought to walk and to please God, even as you do walk, that ye abound more and more. For you know that, you know what charge we gave you through the Lord Jesus Christ. For this is the will of God, even your sanctification, that he abstain from fornication, that each one of you know how to possess himself of his own vessels in sanctification and honor, not in the passion of lust, even as the Gentiles who know not God, that no man transgress and wrong his brother in the matter, because the Lord is an avenger in all these things, as also we forewarn you and testify. For God called us not for uncleanness, but in sanctification. Therefore, he that rejecteth not man, but God, who giveth his Holy Spirit unto
Amen.
You.
Amen.
Let's pray, Father. Thank you for your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to learn that.
Can you correctly to theory?
We can reach a level of knowing if we please God.
Just
right, placing God. Placing God. Because where we have read, you can see that this man says, you have received from us. In other words, we taught you how to walk and to please God. But when he say that he may abound more and more, he was referring to pleasing God. He said, we have taught you how to walk and to please God, even as you walk, that
he
abound more and more and more. Because walking, everybody can still walk. But our walking must be of pleasing God. I'm sure you're hearing that. That's my friend. You need to learn how to praise God. Look here. Pleasing God makes us to do his will for sanctification. There are things that will go away from those things. Like when the Bible talks about abstain from fornication. In other words, there are things that we must abstain from them, because we want to fear God and please him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are three things that have been written there. Number one is abstain, which means that our vessels has been sanctified. Two, we have done away with passion of lust. And the third one is we don't transgress. And all these three things, they need God to deal with someone who's doing it. We abstain. We have done away with lust. But we don't transgress. In other words, we don't hurt anybody. I remember when the Bible said, let us be perfect as
he
is perfect.
Our Father
can give rain
to
everybody.
Meaning
that God loves everybody. And he wants us to be that way.
Because
you cannot hurt anybody if you love someone. You cannot hurt anybody if you love someone. And remember, the Bible says God himself is the avenger. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There's something that I've learned that you can still lie, carry on with lies, but still one day he who sees everyone will bring the results of your life. You know, that's what God is, an avenger. There's a difference between revenge and avenge. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's what I say, my friend.
Abstain
from things and push yourself to sanctification. That's what God wants
tonight.
If you want to please God, you cannot just wake up and please God. There are things you must work on.
Tell me,
if you want to please God, work out your salvation. In Romans 8 verse 8, the Bible shows that when you are in the flesh, you cannot please God. When you are what? In the flesh, you cannot please God. Remember, we are not in the flesh, we are in the spirit. Galatians 5, verse 19. It talks about the fruits of the flesh. The flesh. When you are sinning, you come to church, you can't please God. You know, gone are the days of coming to church when we know that we are doing wrong. I think this is the time now that you cut some things which are wrong. And we stop pretending that we are Christians. I'm sure you understand what I'm talking about.
Amen.
Are you hearing that? I think I have to speak spade to you. If we say we are Christians and we are still sinning, we are wasting our time. Because when Satan throw his arrows to us, we will fail to stop those arrows. Can you see we are wasting time? That's why Ephesians 6
says
we must wear. It means we wear. They have to take these chairs.
You deal with yourself.
Christianity is you deal with yourself. Before God send it to other people, he see you fit that you have dealt with yourself. So if you want to please God, deal with yourself. Because when you're in the flesh, you can't please God. You heard that verse?
Okay.
Look at this one. It says, Galatians 1 verse 10. It says, when we please men, also we cannot be a servant of Christ. Listen to this. This verse shows us that we are going to be challenged by men so that we please them. Therefore, we won't be worthy to serve the Lord. If we please men, we cannot be a servant of Christ, servant of God. It's impossible. I remember when Jeremiah was called, the Bible says, God told him, I said,
Jeremiah,
don't be afraid of their faces. It means Jeremiah was not going to speak good things. We are not called to speak good things only. Remember what happened to John the Baptist. Look what he said to the king. Leave Herodias, it's not your wife. Because we are called to expose sin. Listen, the works or the life of the Spirit exposes the life of the flesh. Because it's like you are light and there's a darkness there.
So
you won't take away darkness away. But the moment the light comes, you can see clear. I'm sure you understand that. If you enter a house which is dark, you won't know the furniture inside. But when you put light, you will see there's a pot there.
Christianity
does not change anything. But unfortunately, it exposes the flesh. So now, when you don't deal with the flesh, if you don't deal with those flesh, you can be part of that.
Otherwise,
you put your life off. Light off. But if your light is always there, don't ever think the flesh will keep quiet. The flesh will say, hey, we don't want to, But carry on lightning. Carry on with the light until that flesh is exposed. I don't know if you're hearing me. I'm just giving you a parable.
As
I say, my friend, what are the works of flesh in you? Ask your neighbor. So now, listen. You have to be challenged by this one. By your brother. Your sister, your wife, your husband, so that you become a servant of Jesus Christ. If you please them when it's wrong, you are not fit for
him.
Do you remember the statement that Peter said?
He said,
we have left all and followed
you.
When God wants to deal with you as a person, you're supposed to please him. Family will come so that you please them. Friends will come. Jesus said, if you love me more than this one, you are not fit of me. I'm sure you hear what I'm going to tell you. As you never say, my friend, are you pleasing God? Or are you pleasing your father? What is your friend answering? Say, tell me, are you pleasing your boyfriend? Or your girlfriend?
Or your girlfriend?
Let's read 1 Corinthians 10. If we read from 1. I want us to read the whole verse.
1 Corinthians 10:1.
For I will not, brethren, have you ignorant that our forefathers were all under the cloud and all passed through the sea and were all baptized unto Moses in the cloud and in the sea and did all eat the same spiritual food and did all drink the same spiritual drink, for they drank of the spiritual rock that followed them, and the rock was Christ. Verse 5, howbeit with the most of them, God was not well pleased. God was not well pleased. For they were overthrown in the wilderness. Now, these things were our examples to the intent we should not lust after evil things.
Amen.
As they also lasted. That's the first thing.
Number
2, neither be ye idolaters as were some of them.
Amen.
Number two.
Three.
The people sat down to eat and drink and rose up to play. Okay, look at these three. Neither let us commit fornication as some of them committed. And fell in one day.
20,000. Amen.
Verse 9. Neither let us make trial of the Lord, as some of them made trial and perished by the serpents.
Amen.
Neither mama ye, as some of them mama and perished by the destroyer. Now, these things happen unto them by the way of example. They were written for our admonition, upon whom the ends of the ages are come. Look here, verse 12.
Verse
Wherefore,
12.
This is the verse I want you to look at it.
Let
him that thinketh
he
standeth take heed lest he fall. That verse is saying we must check us every day. Because whatever happened to them was a lesson for us. God was teaching us that He wants us to please Him. I don't know if you're hearing me. Listen, God can raise any generation anywhere if we are failing to please Him. I mean, one time, there were people who came to Jesus and said, look here, what are you saying about what Pilate did? He destroyed the people and mixed their blood and finished them. And Jesus, if you don't repent, you will die likewise. This is the same example. If we don't please
him,
we will perish like that. What happened was, the Bible says, though they were fed and led from above, they were found not pleasing God. That's what the Bible says. They were found not pleasing God. They were led by the servant of God, Moses. But still they could not please God. They ate manna, the bread of heaven. But still they could not please God. But the time came. God judges them. And they perish in the desert. Buried in the desert. Can I tell you this? If you are pleasing God, God will never allow the promises He has spoken to be finished in the desert. They will come to pass in your life. If you believe, say amen. God will never allow you to move from point A to no point. If you are pleasing Him, He will take you to your destiny. He will take you to where you belong. The Bible says it has been written for our teachings, for our lessons, that though God can feed you, don't congratulate yourself and think you're around. They can still be the same God who can cancel the promises that He promises you. What we need is to please Him. You need to please God. You need to please God. Listen. All promises in Christ are yes and amen. If He say you will take you from Egypt to Canaan, when you please Him, you will reach there. I don't know if you're hearing me. I want to tell some people who are listening to me that this is our lesson. If we want to see all the promises of God, let us not stand against God. Let us please Him. When you please Him, He will take you there. You will never die I mean, not reaching where God never said you reach. You will never die worrying about why you didn't reach there. You will die satisfied. I don't know if you are hearing me. Look here. Look at verse 12 there. Don't think you stood your ground whereas you are not working for your ground. That's the verse that is saying. If you want to see how God is faithful to the people that please Him, number one, look in Hebrews 11 verse 5. The Bible says, Enoch pleased the Lord and God took him. You can see there that there is promotion in pleasing the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Enoch pleased the Lord and God took him. In Proverbs 16 verse 7. When the man's ways
please
the Lord, even his enemies will make peace with him. This shows that your enemies cannot defeat you. Your enemies will never defeat you. Pleasing God makes your enemies to surrender. Stop speaking against your enemy. The Lord is the avenger. Stop praying. Just carry on with him. As if you are not seeing anything. I don't know if you are hearing me. If you do that, your enemies will come and ask forgiveness. I don't know if you are hearing me. Come see your enemy this year bowing in front of you. I said they are bowing in front of you. I see those who are trying to oppose you coming to congratulate you for a higher level. I say this year is your year. This year is your year. It's a year of living your life in fullness. If you please God, those neighbors who don't understand you, you will leave them there to a better place. I've experienced that. Once you have neighbors who don't want you, just love them and pray for them. Just love them and pray. They are telling you are better than them. Even when you look small, they are sensing your future. They are sensing your progress. So the moment you see something like that, just know that you are of a higher level. There's someone who's listening to me today. As you are carrying on pleasing God, God is promoting you. As a God is promoting you. Just as a God is promoting you, your enemies will bow this year. Your opposers will fall this year. Those who are against you will make peace with you because you are better than them. I don't know if you are hearing me. Check somebody say, hey, I want to please the Lord. I want to please the Lord. It's not easy to please the Lord. There are challenges.
Only the challenge
that will come to remove you from where you are. When you pray, sometimes you will feel like God is not even hearing. But carry on. When you carry on, at the end, there's a solution. Pleasing God needs you to finish with yourself. You must finish it with yourself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look at this verse. In John 8, verse 29. Jesus had crowns here. He said, he that sent me is with me, and the Father has not left me, for I do always those things that please him. Can you see that? He said, the one that sent me even now he is with me. Because I please him. There is no way Jesus will leave you if you
please him.
You hear me? There's no way. Here they will try to accuse Jesus. Jesus says, believe me by the works that I do. If you don't believe in me. But Jesus said, I'm not alone on this. Even if people can go away, my Father is with me. Because I do think that places it. Do you know what happens when God wants to work? Your brothers will leave you. Friends, everybody, but you must say, I'm not alone. I'm with him because I please him. I think today, learn not to go by majority. Learn not to go by what? The Lord will look at you when you've got majority, even when you don't have majority. God will look at you. It's a test that, you know, God gave us. Like we pastors, when you start a church, God will look at you. Some people you trust, they don't come to church. So that you check how far you. Sometimes you look at you and say, oh, this one, he trusts me only. He's not looking at the people. He bring more. You know how church grows? It goes by pleasing. If you please God, church will grow. There are two things that can make church to grow. When you please God, or when you rob people. These are two things. Either you rob people, they come to you, you lie to them, they come there. Or you please him only. I don't know if you're hearing me. Ask your neighbor, say, are you pleasing God? Or are you robbing people? Are you hearing that lesson? The church grows if you please God. Or grow when you rob people. Either people come because it's you, but robbing them. Or they come because God sent them. As your neighbor said, my friend, are you pleasing God? Or are you on people? People, when you rob them, or if you win them,
or how about
to yourself, is temporary. It's just temporary. Because very soon you'll be exposed. Very soon you'll be what? But if you please God, God will give you necessary tools, necessary gifts, necessary blessings. What is necessary? What is required? So that you do what is
required.
I don't know if you're hearing me. As your neighbor say, hey, let's please God. Sometimes there are unfavorable situations where we found that it's impossible to do what God wants us to do. The moment you see something like that, know that God is so close. God is so close. When you see something very bad, God is so close. He's looking on you. And he's standing with you. And he has already approved that you will make it. Don't fail him. I said, don't fail him. Can I prophesy something? As you have been pleasing God, God is honoring you. I say he's honoring you today. I say he's honoring you today. He's honoring you. Can I tell you this? Remember Joshua and Caleb.
Opulang Joshua le Caleb.
When they heard about children of Anak.
Aba itwa ka bana ba ba ro ba Anak.
Who were giants.
Ba ne ba le bana ba ba hulu.
They stood their ground. Let's take what God said. They please God. To extend that God was able to speak about them. All of them will die. They won't reach Canaan except Joshua and Caleb. Why? Because they say, let's take what God has
done.
Let's go now. You can please God by believing His word. Tell
neighbor,
you can please God by believing His word. If you please God by believing His word, that does not mean challenges won't come, fear won't come. But because you are holding the word, the Lord will pick you up. The Lord will lift you up. The Lord will raise you up. I don't know if you are hearing me. Check
someone
say, please God by believing in His word. Let me try to finish by telling you this. We also need a prophetic word from the prophet. We please God by holding that word. When you believe the prophets, you know what will happen. You will prosper. You please God by holding that word. You know what happened? The moment the prophet say, God is blessing you, it's not that you see blessings. You will see more shame. So, because the word that came out, it's fighting the one who brought the shame you are facing. So Satan will increase shame so that you doubt the word of the prophet. But the moment you say, I believe God used that man, you will see what he said coming to pass. You must also believe what? The prophet.
Do you
know that the most hated people are prophets. Talked against prophets. Hated prophets. Because they say in your life this will happen. And when it happens, everybody heard it. And everybody will praise God. Let's believe what?
Huh?
Let's believe what? If we do that,
we
will prosper. I say we will prosper. I say you will prosper. Are you ready to please God? In other words, you don't speak against any prophet. You believe prophets. It will happen. How many of you want to please God from today? You hold until you see something. You hold. And you follow him until something happens. Listen. My advice is this. When you are supposed to please God, you can't do it with sin. You'll be tempted. You'll be
tempted.
You know, even now here, I'm not happy. 99% of the people who are here. 99%
ya batho ba baleng moki
are not Christians.
Aba pulusha.
Because you've been tempted.
Ka o ba le lekilwe.
You hear me?
Lengwele.
You've fallen.
Liwile.
Some of you didn't even sleep home yesterday.
Baba ngwa ma.
So how can you please him when you know where you are sleeping? It's not your home. Say it again, Mama. Say it again. In English?
You are not sleeping home.
How can you please God when you know this is your sin.
You
even decorate it. When I'm angry, no one can say anything. You are decorating your sin. That is my advice. You know, I heard one day when I was praying, everybody knows his heart. In your heart, you know what is wrong with your heart. If you know any mistake in your heart, you just know this thing is wrong in you. And you carry on. You are rejecting yourself. And you make God to reject you. If you want God to be happy about you, the moment you find what is wrong, confess it, God will be happy about you. Carry on doing what is right. Carry on doing what is right. When you pray, you just say, at least God, I know the rain is coming and the rain will come. I don't know if you're hearing me. I please God. I know my car is coming. The car will come. I please God. I know my healing is coming. Your healing will come. If you please God, even if it's not yet time for you to receive, because you please God, God will give you before time. You will receive before time. I don't know if you are hearing me. You don't need to wait for a certain time. Even now. If you please God now, something will happen. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Do you know why? You must go and read about the centurion. When he reached there to Jesus, he said, please, my servant. Jesus said, I will come and heal the person. What is it that the man said? Sorry, sir. You don't need to come to my house. Jesus said, ha. This man said, I will heal. So, when Jesus listened, he said, please, I'm a man of command. Whatever I say to myself, that go, he go. So I know this happened. Even you, I know you. If you say something, I know it will happen. Jesus was pleased. He never prayed. He just said, go. It has happened to you. You don't need to pray. If you reach that level, you say something, it will happen. I don't know if you are hearing me. You say something because you please God, it will happen. Jesus will say, yes, it will happen and it happens. I don't know if you are hearing me. Can I prophesy you? This week, what you are desiring, you are receiving it in the name of Jesus. I know. It's happening now. I say it's happening right now. I know you are receiving it right now. I say you are receiving it right now. Your car, your house, your job, your business is right now, right here. I know. Take it in the name of Jesus. If you believe, shout hallelujah. You know, pleasing God is so sharp. It's more than fasting prayers. Because for you to please God, to entrust it with riches, you must manage poverty. You must go through poverty and become happy in poverty with Him. So when He bless you, blessing will never control you. I don't know if you are hearing me. If you are here, you are listening to me. The main issue from now is not money,
as chelete,
houses,
as it in tony,
boyfriend, girlfriend,
as a boyfriend, yauli girlfriend, nyati,
whatever.
Obachonache we.
The main issue is him, you and him. When now you've got good rights together, right
standing together.
you will open your eyes.
O tla gona o bola matho.
You begin to see him now saying this. This one is not part of
you.
That one is not part of
you.
Listen, if you don't please him, your eyes will be
blind.
Even your decisions, your plans are wrong because you can't see where you're going. Can you see why people are just do decision today, tomorrow they change?
They change.
You go to school, you want to study this. Next time you do this. Are you hearing me? It's because you were blind. When you reach there, you realize, I'm not supposed to be here. You study engineering, you realize you're supposed to be a doctor. You become a doctor, you realize you're supposed to be a cleaner. Because what places God places your heart. And it brings joy in your heart. You carry on doing it effectively. You do it without grudging or being pushed. You do it with all your heart. I don't know if you're hearing me. From now on, you must check what places him in you. Do it, you will have peace. Do it, you have joy. Do it, God will open your doors. Even if it looks like it's closed, but at the end you will reach there. There are many of you are listening to me today. God is resurrecting you. He's lifting you to a higher level. And if you believe, shout hallelujah. Let me stop there. Let me call people for altar call.
Those
who want to accept Jesus, come. Others are doing things that displeases him. Come now. Come and study here. We pray with you. Come. You want to please him, but sin is working against you. And this come, we play a song. On Calvary, mercy there was great, and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied to me. There my burden soul found liberty. Oh, it comes.
Liberty.
Merci, merci.
Merci, merci. Mercy there was great and grace was free.
Oh, yeah.
Pardon was multiplied to me.
Oh,
there my burden so foundly body.
Raise up your hands, close your eyes, and repeat after me. Say,
Lord Jesus,
I come to you today.
I believe in my heart,
and I confess with my mouth
that you died for my sins
on the cross of Calvary.
Come into my life,
erase my name
in the book of death.
And write my name
in the book of life.
From today onwards,
be my Lord and Savior.
I will follow you
all the days of my life.
In Jesus' name,
I am born again.
Amen.
Welcome to the family of God. Welcome. Come, Joseph, come. Lay hands on these people. You just lay hands on them, they go back just like that. Come, Malihori. Yes, Malihori, come. Also, yes. Just lay hands on them, let them go just like that. Yes, thank you. After they lay hands on you, go back. Go back. Mercy, 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 there was grace and grace.
Grace was free.
Oh, pardon,
then there was multiplied to me.
Oh, there
my
burden
so foundly
body
it mercy there
was
great and grace was free.
Oh,
pardon
there
was multiplied
to me.
Oh, there my burden so profoundly body it Calvary.